Good morning, YouTube. Today, we're going to try something new. We're going to go to Coffee with Cars in Killeen. I don't know. Actually, is it Killeen or Killeen?
Porn cat on man anal.
Anyway, it's about 60, 65 miles north of Austin, so it's going to take us about an hour to get there. And the reason I want to go to it is, number one, I've never been to that car show. And I haven't been to Killeen and I don't know, like a year or two or three. And then the final reason is that the Fort Hood Army Base is like right there at Killeen. So there's a crapload of like military people that are in the area. And like, what does that have to do with cars? Well, I don't know why, but for some reason, lots and lots of military people are really into cars. So I suspect we're going to have a lot of really serious gearheads there, which is cool. Finally, I guess the ultimate reason, it's an excuse to drive. We're going to go meet up with the elite guys, drive up in a group. Probably take some back roads, have some fun driving, see some cars, and grab lunch and head home. So that's kind of the plan for the day. My guess is we're gonna see a lot of Camaros and Mustangs and Corvettes and American muscle cars, that sort of stuff. That's kind of, you know, I mean, it is military people, you know, America. Fuck yeah. Let's head on out and see some awesome stuff. These cars don't run.
How you doing, buddy?
We got the Mercedes crew.
The Germans.
The Germans are here. The fucking running.
I mean, technically
it is a German meet today. Like, well, it's, you know, cars and coffee, but they're trying to attract more German cars.
Kind of a German car fest. One of us.
Not like the others.
Oh shit, I am the only non-German today.
But for a while you couldn't tell the difference.
Well, I mean, they got some, you know, heritage that's, you know, fascist together.
There you go. Yes. Yes.
The V12 is what makes that incredible. The sound of those things is fucking awesome. I absolutely love the BMW wagons. I think that is the shit right there.
VF Engineering. Nice.
Something tells me it might scoot a little. That is cars and coffee, literally. It's interesting with the silver side blade instead of the carbon or black or any other color. Skittles, yeah. Nice, good looking.
I like the, yeah, no, I mean, if you're gonna have a fun car, why not have it stand out? Oh, look at, they even got the Hot Wheels. Nice. That is sweet.
I love the little rotors in the seats. That is so badass.
Oh, yes. Yes.
All right, I know I shit on the new NSX, but see, the reason I did is because that is fucking cool. The new one, eh, not that great. That's badass right there.
Yeah. Turbo hiding down there.
Yep.
Yeah. Nice.
It's probably faster in my car.
There.
Y'all know I had a 71 Cutlass, right? I don't know, it's not a 71, but I don't know.
I think it's a 72 or 73.
I'm not sure, but that car was fun. It had a 455.
So I roll in the window and he comes up and he goes, you know, I pulled you over. I said, yeah, I was going fast. Yeah, I'm doing 85 and a 55. He goes, where are y'all headed? I go to Houston. Where are y'all coming from? Oh, I go, my wife and I, we help save dogs from kill shelters to non-kill shelters. We transport them so they get saved.
Right. Bob Barker, reminding you, help control the pet population. Have your pets spayed or neutered.
And he goes, He hands me my license back. He goes, here.
No shit.
Just slow down. I'm like, wow. What? I go, are you sure? He goes, look, I have four rescues at home. Wow. I love what you guys do. Just slow it down. I'm gonna take you on a ride. We're gonna burn through the night.
Why you so salty? I'll still take a bite. Okay. Badass right here.
That's fucking awesome right there.
Look at, you got the Buc-ee's.
All right, just found my favorite car here. Definitely.
Yes. Yeah, it's fucking awesome.
I love talking to people who love cars. It's fun. Just talking to these two old guys right there. They're awesome. They're asking me all these cool questions and, like, you know, dispelling Ferrari myths. That's what you gotta do.
Yep.
Barely clearing it.
I'll give them credit. It's unique. Those are definitely cutouts because the sound is not coming from the back of the car. It's coming from the middle.
Yes.
Yes.
He sharpened it out.
Do a lot of interviews.
Oh yeah.
Ever since I owned got this Corvette, a lot of things have been going good in my life. Richard here from Texas Street Cars. I used to own a Camaro, boys, but not anymore. Let me say I stepped up. The best way I can describe the step up I made is stepping from an 85 Camaro, right? And you went to basically a Ferrari Testarossa. That's what the Corvette is. You can look on the side, it's got the gills on the side. Ferrari actually took that design, put it down the Testarossa, but it was here first. And ever since I bought it, I just feel different, you know? I got a lot more gold, got a lot more jewelry, got a lot more friends. Last night, coming here, I came in from out of town from the state prison, but I got out last night, got the car basically for free, and I raced a Hellcat last night, boys. I'm gonna live with y'all. Raced a Hellcat on the highway, and I assume it was a Hellcat because it had a little cat on the side of it. But he didn't know he's going up against. The TT right there on the Corvette, you see how the T's are connected? That stands for probably twin turbo. I haven't looked at the underhood too much. I beat the Hellcat by 6 Hellcats, which is equivalent to like a Titanic or so. They're real big cars. And when I got it, I got all this gear with it. It was in the car. These jean shorts. I had to order the New Balances. Well, their New Balance teamed with Corvette and the Corvette Museum. They invited me up. They issued me the shoes from the guys use these shoes in the C7R, the race car that beat all the Ford stuff, you know, beat the Ford GT, beat all these Ferraris. Can't beat a Corvette. They're gonna go to mid-engine next year. I'll probably eat my gun, but you know, it's not that bad of a deal, I guess. You like the mid-engines? Anybody like? Nobody does. Corvette stays front engine. Well, what does Corvette stands for something? It's French for America, I think. That's what Corvette's French for. But we don't talk about the French though. But yeah, y'all check it out and feel free to crawl underneath it. It's all made of fiberglass, so there's no rust. Y'all check it out. Richard's out.
All right, the Corvette guy made the whole trip worthwhile. That was absolutely fucking hilarious. Oh my God. Definitely got a V8 in that thing. Yeah.
All those poor things have all been slaughtered now. See you, man. Drive safe.
Will do. See ya.
Drive fast. $5.
Digging the color.
No, that's the real color.
Yeah,
that's
is it really?
Yeah.
Not wow.
A wrap. Not a wrap.
That is a really unique paint job. Really pretty.
See you guys.
See you, man.
See you next time.
Drive fast and fun, but safe.
All right, back at home. It's starting to get pretty hot, so I'm gonna wrap this up quick. Pretty sweet. On the way home, ran into Ferrari California. So I rode with that guy for a little while. It's always fun. It's really strange, but since having the Ferrari, I've just randomly come across, I think, three or four times I've run across other Ferraris, and it's always funny just to like wave and smile and whatever, and you know, I don't know, whatever. Anyway, it's cheesy, but it's kind of cool because then inevitably you end up like farting around with each other. I don't know why there was a lot of cops on the way home, so I couldn't really go super fast. Kind of sucked. So the Killeen, whatever, that, the coffee and cars was actually really good. Pretty fun, really nice people, a lot of good people to talk to. And holy shit, the guy with the Corvette was hilarious. Oh my God, that was so funny. That right there made it worth it alone. So hopefully you guys enjoyed that. Yeah, I think I'll have to go out there again. I don't know when, but one of these months I'll go out there again because that was a lot of fun. It's good roads out there, you know, I get to do some fun driving. So I need to go get in some air conditioning. You guys are amazing. Stay cool if you're somewhere like Texas. Yeah, you know, do those things, click these buttons and, you know, click that button and maybe even share this video. So I appreciate when you guys share these videos. It helps my videos go up in ranking and then YouTube promotes me and it makes me happy. Then I go, wee, something like that. All right. We'll see you guys soon. We're gonna do more car stuff. It's gonna be sweet.